Hi and hello friends. And my beautiful, handsome, pretty, young and old family friends of my YouTube. Thank you very much for following me. I enjoy being with you, talking to you and sharing it during this time to all of you. Please continue to support me in this manner that you have been doing by watching some of the blogs that I have been putting up. And it is nice to know our past. And today, I want to ask each one of you something. How many of you would like to be called the lion or the place where you live in, or the prince, or the ruler, or the commander of the army of that particular place you live in? In history, we find there are a lot of people who have been called by certain names, signifying their bravery, their patriotism, and their personality to go beyond their call of duty to perform for their motherland. And that has been the dream of many, especially those who join the army. We find that they have a dream to protect the nation. And that dream, they go beyond as to sacrifice their lives for them. And it is a matter of pride that we should be able to understand the sacrifice of these brave people in the army and the defense who go out and challenge the enemy who try to destroy our nation. So let's try to salute them and also respect them, because they are doing a great service to this nation and they are keeping us safe from all kinds of danger. So a big thank you to them for the sacrifice. Recently they did it in the China-India border, and I like to salute them for their bravery and for their a passion to sacrifice their life for this nation. Today I'm going to talk to you about another great personality in our history, especially from the state of Manipur. Oh, when I talk about Manipur, I have to mention that is my second home. I have three places where I can go and visit. That is, one is in Jharkhand, one is in Manipur, and presently where I'm staying right now. So Manipur I know very well, because it's my home there, and I have gone to various places of Manipur while working there and also visiting with friends. So I know quite a lot about Manipur, and especially the present Manipur. What I'm going to talk to you is today about the past history of Manipur and the true patriot of Manipur was no other than Tikendrajit Singh. Manipuri people have the Singh, which signifies certain clan or class of people. Tikendrajit Singh was one of the brothers who belonged from a royal family who were presently at that period of time ruling Manipur. The period that I'm talking about is 1856 to 1891. That was the period when Tikendrajit Singh, he was born and he died in 1891. So he led the revolt against the colonial rule which was imposed on them. Remember, Manipur was a princely state from long before. It was ruled by kings. And the last king to rule Manipur was one of his brothers. We'll talk about his brother, that is Kulachandra Singh. Now, on 29th December, Tikendrajit Singh was born into this royal family His father's name was Chandrakirti Singh. As the story goes on, the father got ill, so now the death of his father promoted the eldest son to ascend the throne of Manipur. The eldest son's name is Sur Chandra Singh. The eldest brother of Tikendarjit, he went and ascended the throne after the death of their father. Now, Tikendarjit Singh was such an able, freedom-loving, patriotic individual that he was not really happy with the way the Manipur was handled after the coming of the Britishers. Remember, British had already gone into Burma and slowly they were trying to expand into Manipur. So when
Bir Tikendrajit Singh
and the brothers, they revolted against Sur Chandra, the eldest brother who was sitting on the throne, Tikendrajit Singh and his brothers, they left the palace. And when Kula Chandra ascended the throne, Tikendrajit Singh was made the Jubaraj. That was title given to him. This history records it as a palace revolt. It mentions that this revolt took place and the name was given as palace revolt. Sur Chandra left Imphal and he went to Brindavan when his brother revolted against him. Brindavan is somewhere in Bengal. But on his way, he changed his direction and went to meet the British commissioner who was there in Kolkata. His name was Lord Lansdowne. And he went to him and requested him, "Please help me to retain back my throne." This British officer, instead of helping him, he put Kula Chandra, retained him as the Maharaja of that princely state of Manipur, but he said, "I want Tikendrajit Singh." That was the bargain put by the Britishers. On March 22, 1891, Chief Commissioner J.W. Quinton, he sent an army to capture Tikendrajit Singh, but Tikendrajit Singh escaped that time. On March 24, the British army with their armed force, they invaded the palace compound. There, the women and the children, they were playing, watching Ras Leela. During that time, the British army invaded the palace and killed many young children and women, plus the army and the soldiers who were guarding the palace. It was a sad occasion. Who will tolerate such an insult to their king? Foreigners can come and invade the palace and kill the women, children and everyone who was found to be there. It was a sad thing. So the public was aroused. Tikendrajit Singh was there and so they attacked the Britishers, and five British officers with the army they were with, they were killed on that day. When the British High Commissioners who were sitting in Kolkata heard this, they sent three columns of army, one from Kohima, one from Silchar and one from
Burma, now Myanmar.
On April 27, the Kangla Palace was invaded and the whole palace sadly was taken by the Britishers under the leadership of Maxwell. They installed a miner, his name was Chandrakanta Singh, to sit on the throne of Manipur, just to sit. Administration and whatever the Britishers would do it. So they installed Chandrakanta to sit on the throne of Manipur because the whole country now was overtaken by the Britishers. Tikendrajit Singh and one Thangal general was there. His name also should not be forgotten in this war, Anglo-Manipur war which took place. They were captured and they were killed. In fact, they were hanged. And it was a great sad occasion because this was a great person who again laid down his life to not to allow colonial rule to rule over it. He was also given many beautiful titles. And at present, if you go to proper Imphal, just next to the polo ground, there's a football stadium next to the polo ground. There's a beautiful memorial, war memorial, built in his memory. And it is known as the Tikendrajit Park, where the sacrifice of Tikendrajit Singh has been installed. Because it is right in the center of the city, so it is accessible by walking distance. It is just from the main city, it is just maybe 100 to 50 steps from different direction. It is very near. And the Kangla Fort, it was never handed back to the Manipuri people, except for the temple which is inside. For many, many years, the armies were inside. Indian army was occupying it. People used to go to the temple after getting frisked by the army. So from ages, that has been from the Britishers. It was handed over to the Indian army, and the Indian army was looking after the fort of that area, where the palace compound is a little further down, but that important place of history was surrounded by the army. They had an army camp there. Tikendrajit Singh, they were hanged publicly in that spot where I was talking to you about, where his memorial has been built. It's a beautiful place. They have done it so well. Though it has become very in the middle of the city, but it is nice to see what all. You can read what he did. It has been mentioned very nicely there, what all he was and his sacrifice. Now, Tikendrajit Singh will be always remembered for his bravery, for his leadership quality, and also for his patriotism. The heroic deeds that he did. I cannot tell everything what he did because it will become too lengthy. And as many of you have requested to make it short, but that's what I'm trying to make it shorter, so that you will learn certain things and you will try to remember. So this brave patriot of Manipur is also known as the Lion of Manipur. He did this for his nation and he is fondly remembered even till now, because on his death Manipur government has given a date, a state holiday, which is known as the Patriot Day, to celebrate and remember the sacrifice of Tikendrajit Singh. Thank you for going through me as we went through this great individual and what he did for the freedom of his country. Let's remember and salute them for the sacrifice they laid so that we can enjoy this freedom that we have. Until then, my friends, please continue to watch and let's learn together, and it will be a good experience. Thank you.